And in this, we've got Calvin Smith, one of the favourites for a medal, running in lane 7 for the Americans. Here now is Ron Pickering.
Well, the sprinters have got perfect conditions, and there's 13 heats. Not exactly a packed stadium first morning, but they will get the chance to see the great sprinters in action. And the first three in each of the heats go through to the second round, plus 9. And there's the lineup. It's Muyaba from Zimbabwe, the Algerian Selmi, the Hungarian Kovac, who should be one of the three, Mardi from Indonesia, then Ndinga from the Congo, Ratzin from the Soviet Union, another of the probable qualifiers, and Calvin Smith, former world record holder, in lane 7, with a man from Liechtenstein on his right. So there's a fair spread in this international. There's Calvin Smith going to his blocks, the unrecognised hero of sprinting, really, in the shadow of Carl Lewis and Ben Johnson, but my word, he's capable of some upsets here. He's been around a long while. He's been a superb sprinter, the greatest third leg sprinter in the world on that American relay team, but the world champion in 83 and 88 at 200 meters, quite apart from a gold medalist in the relay. And although he occasionally, in the politest way, complains about he not being in the limelight, I think he likes the lower profile. He's smaller than either Lewis or Johnson. He's a flapper. He runs on top of the ground. He doesn't drive power. He hasn't got the power expression that the other two have, although, of course, Carl Lewis is an elegant sprinter. But this guy's a flapper with his arms waving about all over the place. You wouldn't use him for a film on sprinting to demonstrate to youngsters, but you would his attitude and you would his results. Calvin Smith, who has run 9.93 back in 83, and here in this lineup of the second heat, of which the first three go forward, plus 9 from all the heats into the second round.
What about the first heat, run by Robson Silva of Brazil, 10.37, Madonia of Italy in second place, 10.40, and Cheng of Taipei, third, 10.48.
Well, 5.29, just saw bouncing up and down, Kovac of Hungary, Hungarian record holder. And there's the there's Mardi from Indonesia, who's run 10.32, so he's very good. In red, Henry Ndinga from the Congo. This might be a new experience for him. The Soviet Union's Andrei Ratzin, who's a 10-2 man, Soviet 100-meter champion. Calvin Smith, be puffing away. He's probably still chewing his gum, which is his trademark. And then Markus Büschel of Liechtenstein. And the crowd, we cut away. You're seeing on the far side, there's a bigger crowd on this side, as a matter of fact. So there must be 35,000 people in the stadium, although this 100,000-seater stadium looks relatively half empty. Calvin Smith, lane 7, then. Good man on his left from the Soviet Union, Ratzin. And in lane 3, Kovac. Good discipline at the start. And Calvin Smith gets away, and he's really flying, but on his left, it's Ratzin. And now Calvin breaks away in the middle, though. It's away from Ratzin. Mardi and Kovac were the other two, and Ratzin will have to wait. And I may have done Mardi an injustice. I said he ran 10.32, and he looked pretty impressive in lane 4. Kovac was another of the qualifiers, but there was no problem to Calvin Smith in lane 7. Just having a look at the scoreboard to see whether his time has gone up. 10.27. 10.27, and here he is. Well, he's looking better. He usually has, he's got his fists clenched rather more than he usually has. He usually has his fingers pointed, but it's pretty good stuff. Watch the relaxation of the facial muscles there. And he has just a look over to his left, because that's where his, the nearest men to him are. Mardi in lane 4, Attila Kovac in lane 3, but Calvin Smith home and dry. 10.27 is time.